Yummy, 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 I got love in my tummy, and I feel like I'm loving you. Love you, such a sweet thing, good enough to eat thing, and it's just what I'm gonna do. Hi, everybody. I'm Karol with a K. And I'm going to show you today how to make these terrific love bugs. And really, they aren't as hard as everybody has been trying to figure out. This is the book that we were taking it from, and it tells you the supplies that we need. We need 5 fat quarters. And by fat quarters, they're 18 by 22 inches. And so this is going to be the back of the love bug. Okay. Now, I've got things laid out here, but let's try to do it like this. This is going to be the belly of the love bug. He's going to be blue-bellied. And this love bug is so cute. This love bug has got Winnie the Pooh. And how many of you like Winnie the Pooh? Well, Winnie the Pooh is going to be put on like this, and it's going to have wings. So Winnie's going to fly. And we're going to do it similar like this. This is what it looks like right at the moment. But I'm going to teach you how to do this. And this love bug, when it's all done, you can put a little note inside here, inside these wings. So let's get started. With the back, you're going to take and you're going to get a 16 or 17 inch circle. And you're going to lay it on the back of your material. The one where you're going to put on the back part of the belt, the love bug. And you're going to trace it, or you're just going to cut all the way around this circle. It's up to you. But in my case, I traced it. And I will cut it out with scissors all the way around. Stop. Okay, start with this. We're going to cut it out like so. Now, this is Darcy's, and she really likes this. And she picked this stripe material out, which I am so glad is on the back, because stripes go, they make me crazy. They move around as I'm doing them. Now, as you can see, it's not that hard. This is something that is a very easy project, something that anybody can do. And if we can teach the girls at St. Joe's Academy to do it, you ought to be able to do it also. I'm almost finished here. Now, what I've done also, I've already ironed this a little bit. I kind of cheated a little bit. But what I did, here's your circle. Now, what I did is I ironed this like so. And I got it in the middle. And then I ironed it like so, this way also, half that way. And there's a reason for that. Okay, so I am going to show you now how to place all of your pieces together. Remember, these are fat quarters and they're lots of fun. And it's really easy, our kits that we have for you. They're already made up. All you have to do is put them together. Now, here is the belly, as I said earlier. Here is Winnie. Now, when you put this down, I have already creased this, as you can see. So we know it's the middle. Okay? We're going to lay this down like this. We're going to take this piece with its fold right here. And we're going to take this and put this right here and right here. And it's going to be 4 inches. Oh boy, I couldn't have done that better if I tried. Okay, and then we're going to put the other one down. And it's also folded. Remember, we folded the material and we wanted to put, oh dear, I put Winnie, I put, what's his name on the wrong side?
Eeyore.
Eeyore. I put Eeyore on the wrong side.
Now, Karol, why are you putting the fabric like that?
Well, because we want to take this and we want to make this the wing. And we want to have it take and fold it. That's why this crease is in here. So that we know that we've got the wing where it should be. And I will explain this. You're going to come over that little crease again that's coming up. And you're going to come down to 4 inches. And you're gonna come down to 4 inches here. Okay.
And you're also
now, that looks really weird, doesn't it? But believe me, it's all gonna work out in the end.
And what's this material called when it has a pattern on it? Isn't it a facing pattern?
It's the fat quarter pattern. What are you talking about?
Why do you have to have the, aren't you putting this because you have a pattern on it?
I want to make it directional. And if it was the other way, just think of it like this. If I had the material that had a directional print on it, which this does, but we're lucky because it's going in that direction. You would have a wing like this. And see, everything would be going sideways. That's why we want it to go this way, so we know everything's, and the kids won't get confused. They'll be like me. Okay, now there's that. Now we have to put the head on. Okay, so we know that the head has to go exactly right there, and it has to go right in the middle. So we want to make sure we match it up. It can come up a little bit higher. Okay, and it can come up, it's right about right there. Look at that. Doesn't look like much right now, does it? But here's where everything comes together. Remember this piece for the back? We're gonna lay the fold on the fold, the fold on the fold, and what we want, that head is gonna come right on the fold there. Look at that. Isn't that great?
That's awesome.
And we're gonna take this and we're gonna sew it from here all the way around. But before we do that, don't love bugs have legs? Of course they do. So what we decided to do was take these little ribbons that we got and we're gonna put them. Now you don't want them this way because they're not gonna, it won't work, because they'll be inside the love bug and he'll eat them up. So we want them to come this way and you can start putting one right about there, just a little bit below the belly. Put another one a little bit above this line here, his wing, and then kind of eyeball it here and put one in the middle. Okay, and that's how that would be. And the same thing on the other side. Well, you don't want to have a love bug with just legs on one side. You want it on both sides. So, I don't know where the other piece went, but it went someplace. Oh, there it is. It flew away. The love bug didn't want it. Okay, we found it. Okay, so now that's all going to be in here. And you're going to sew this. And you're gonna start here, and you're gonna sew all the way around. And you're gonna come in a half an inch, by the way. Remember, we want it to come in about this far. Okay? You could measure if you want. You could make your line so you don't go off course. But you'll catch on when you're on your sewing machine. So you're gonna sew all the way around. You're gonna make sure you catch those little legs. Okay, now, when everything is all together, this one doesn't have legs, it's gonna look like this. You see, this one didn't get its legs put in. This poor little guy, he's gonna be without legs. Mm-hmm. He's not gonna get too far. But it needs buttons on it. So we're gonna use this little love bug for the moment. And what we're going to do is we're just going to sew these on. You can take this like this and sew them on. Or you can take, like a couple of girls have done, and they've taken some pieces of material and put them on there. And like with a double facing, pelon facing, so that they'll stick right there and iron them on. Then what you do after everything is in, then you're going to take and you're going to stuff this little guy. And you really want to make the hole a little bit bigger than this, but you're going to stuff them so you can put your hand in there. And you're going to put all that stuffing in there to make him real foamy and nice and cuddly. Now remember, these are for kids. And we want to put a little message maybe in here. Something to let them know that they are loved. And this love bug loves them too. So I think really and truly, it's not that hard. We just make it hard when we try to read instructions. But sometimes somebody showing you how to do it makes it a lot easier. So I hope this was helpful. I hope you enjoy making them. And we need more than 50. So come on, let's get them done. And we have all kinds of kits. They're free. How about that? You don't get free stuff too often anymore, do you?
You do not.
So come on down, pick up a kit, and make a love bug. Thanks a lot. Nice seeing you.